Welcome, Power fans. The Power have made history today with a 116-109 victory over the defending champions, the Windsor Express. This is their first game ever in the playoffs. Coach, that was quite an emotional game. Tell me about the fourth quarter. You got teed up and the motivation and the way that the team played after you left.
Well, you know, it's been an emotional time for us the last couple of days. We've had some off-court issues that we've worked through or been trying to work through. We've had some injuries. You know, the whole year's been up and down and way more down than up, you know, with players leaving and being hurt. And we had a system and a goal tonight to execute a certain way. And we had done that last game for what we called 75%, you know, two-thirds. We really executed well and then kind of died. Tonight was the same good start, and it was the same good second quarter. It was the same decent third quarter, and we were into the fourth, and we didn't let up, whereas last game we had let up some. And as a result, it got real emotional. It got real serious. It got real intense. I thought that there was an absolutely awful call, probably the worst call I ever seen in my life. And so I snapped, lost it, and got ejected. And there was 3 minutes left, and I was not proud of that. I was not happy with myself about that. But our staff is on the same page. And you know what? We've worked so hard on the details with our guys that they knew what to do. As I said earlier, the inbounds plays were called properly. The timeout, the last timeout that was left, was used properly. We got the advance. Guys made their free throws. Guys got the ball in. And it was interesting because we were in that situation against Windsor a couple weeks ago, and we turned the ball over and made a poor decision. And same player had it today. No turnover. Gets fouled. Goes to the foul line. Makes us both ices. The game was awesome.
Oh yeah, it was incredible. The Power didn't even let up a lead once.
Nope.
This game, and that's been few and far between all season.
Of course.
But they've been progressing since the first game of the playoffs to now. What do you think the key was for them to keep the lead and stay in control?
One word, we just talked about trust. And I've been talking about trust. Trust the game plan. Trust what I think is going to work, because you have to. That I'm the coach and you play for me. Trust it. We haven't had great trust all year. And you can't blame these guys. We lose a couple, and a handful of those were my fault, no question. We lose a couple and you start to trust less. You win. Oh, okay, it's working. Easy to trust, right? And so we unfortunately, I even hate to say it, but we've had some moral victories in the last couple weeks. And within those moral victories, I can pinpoint what's working. Mm-hmm. And so today, this weekend, it was about trust. Trust each other. Trust what you're going to do. Trust it with it when it gets hostile, when it gets heated in there, when it gets intense. And they did. They just executed and did what we wanted offensively and defensively with a few lapses all game. And I said, if you trust everything, it'll be close down the stretch and we'll figure it out. And in fact, we had a 10-point cushion.
Now, where does trust factor in on a performance of Toot Roush, who dropped 48 points? It's a team record.
Well, you know what? Nobody knows Toot better than me. And Toot, I've told Toot how proud I have been of him lately. You know, he had a really good start to the year. He got hurt, and he came back, and I had a hard time giving him a lot of minutes. He just didn't look good when he first came back. And as a result, I know he's been upset with me throughout the year. I've even had his family yelling at me, and rightfully so. You know, rightfully so. But what happened with Toot, and I told him and I told the guys, I said, this guy's a pro, he's staying positive, and he kept working. And lately, he's had really, really good moments. And I felt bad about the last game. You know, I thought, looking back in hindsight, I should have played him more in the second half, and I didn't. And today I let him go the whole time, and he was absolutely phenomenal. It's a testament to his character, and I've known him for a long time, but it's a testament to his skill level. He really is that good. I probably haven't used him as good as I probably could have overall, but the kid stayed positive and he stayed working, and I could not be more proud of anyone than I am of him right now.
He definitely let his actions speak for him tonight.
Exactly.
But then there's Jordan Widener, who's been a whole new player since the playoffs started. He's he's this year's first round draft pick.
Yep.
Did you see this in him when you drafted him?
I did. I swear. I honestly did. Everybody questioned me. Why are you drafting this kid? Why? He's not athletic. He's not this. He's not that. I told everybody, just leave me alone. I know what I'm looking at. I know toughness when I see it. He is tough. You know, you can rag on him, you can beat him down, you can, it doesn't matter what you do, he comes to play professionally all the time. He's had a handful of games like this, just had the typical rookie year, the up and down, and I know what that's like. But I've had a connection with Jordan. He has reminded me of myself from the time I've seen him. He's probably a better player than I was, but the way he approaches the game, I have a fundamental respect for that, and I knew he was going to be good. I told him I wanted to bring him back next year a long time ago. I'm not surprised tonight. I'm not. He just did a better job of staying like like relaxed the whole time. Because as rookies, sometimes they get a little bit up and a little bit down emotionally during the game, but he stayed relaxed the whole night. They had an outstanding game.
And I noticed at some point he had to calm the team down, especially in the second half.
Yeah.
So it was good to see that they actually stuck with it.
Yeah.
Now let's look forward to Tuesday.
Yeah.
Game four.
Yeah.
We're going to continue on this streak.
Yeah.
What is the plan to keep the Power on the high road?
You know what? Trust. Just trust the game plan. They're the same players. The game plan's not going to change. We might add something new offensively, maybe something defensively. Probably not. Just trust. Mm-hmm. And this is what happens when you trust. When you trust what's going on, you trust the game plan. If it's good and if it's working, you'll win.
It's so funny you say trust. That's actually one of my sayings. I'll be like, trust.
Yeah.
And let it happen.
Yeah.
So we'll see it happen on Tuesday, March 17th, when Windsor comes back to the Hershey Center for Game 4. We'll see you then.